Thank you. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Thomas Jefferson Arts Academy. I want to encourage everyone to find a seat. We did hold curtain for a few minutes. Thank you for your patience. We had a long line at the door, which is a good problem to have, and we're thrilled to have you here. I'm not going to say too much. I do want to warn everyone that there will be some traffic up and down the aisles on either side of the theater. So just like an airplane, if you're in the aisles, I want you to make sure you keep your feet and arms tucked in so that no one gets hurt, particularly on this side. People run pretty quickly up the aisle.
Les quiero advertir que los actores en algunos momentos pueden salir corriendo y subir por el pasillo a los dos costados. Entonces, si estás sentado en la punta, les pido que mantengas las manos y los pies dentro del asiento para que no se dañe nadie.
Okay, we're going to close the doors. Welcome to Once Upon a Mattress. Enjoy the show.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Thomas Jefferson Arts Academy. We hope you enjoy tonight's performance. To ensure this, we ask that you not eat or drink in the theater. As a courtesy to the performers, flash photography and videotaping is strictly prohibited. Also, kindly remember to turn off your cell phones and electronic devices. Now sit back, relax, and enjoy the show. Thank you for your cooperation and attendance.
Thank you. Concerns famous rulers. Are you quite ready?
Uh-huh.
Well then, name three kings. Is that clear?
Yes. Would you repeat the question, please?
Certainly. Name three kings.
May I take the third king first? Well then, the three kings are...
Is this a trial?
No, it's the royalty test to see if she's a real princess.
King John, King Arthur, and...
Does it matter if she's a true princess?
Oh, yes. If she's a true princess, we can all get married. King Ethelred.
That is absolutely correct.
She's smart, Mama. She's the best one yet. Can I marry your Mama? Can I?
No, sweetheart. There's still one more question.
This test isn't going to be fair.
It's the law that isn't fair.
The law?
The marriage law. Throughout the land, no one may wed until dauntless at an altar's led.
Dauntless?
The prince. Until he gets married, none of us can.
You have now reached the seventh plateau, and here is your final question. First, it is divided into four parts and concerns a very famous man, often regarded as the Knight of the Red Cross. One, what was his name? Two, what beast did he slay? Three, how many rows of teeth did the beast have and what kind? And four, what was the middle name of the daughter-in-law, of the best friend, of the blacksmith that forged the sword that killed the beast?
One, St. George. Two, the dragon. Three, 12 rows of teeth, and they were iron. Four, Would you repeat the question, please?
What was the middle name of the daughter-in-law, of the best friend, of the blacksmith that forged the sword that killed the beast?
The middle name.
The middle name.
The daughter-in-law.
In-law. You have 30 seconds.
Oh, pass. Please, please, pass.
Do you speak, Halevi?
No, I...
20 seconds.
Oh.
I wish her success. She's a pretty little thing.
10 seconds.
Oh.
I'm terribly sorry. Your time is up.
Too bad, my dear, too bad. You do show a certain aptitude, but as for the true brilliance of royalty, well, I'm afraid not. However, goodbye. Oh, wait, no! Your prize. Now, goodbye, good luck, and get out! Sweethearts, Dauntless, don't dilly-dally. Now, don't dilly-dally, Dauntless, it's nearly time for your cocoa.
Oh, I liked her. Why must every princess get the bird?
It's just absurd. I've never heard a test so difficult to pass.
Alas, alas, is what I lack. I lack, alas, alas, alack.
Splendid. Watch close. I take this perfect, plain piece of parchment with no folds, creases, or concealed pockets. What do you want?
Excuse me, Cardamon, but I have to take the minstrel to sign in with the castle steward.
Oh, I'm on my way to the party. I won't be staying long.
Yes. For your father's sake, I put up a good deal from you. Don't address me as Cardamon in court just because your father and I were in show business together. Don't presume.
Oh! Oh! Sir Harry!
My darling, you missed the test.
Sweet Larkin, my responsibilities is chivalric knight of the herald. Keep me busy.
The latest princess was a failure.
No.
Yes.
Well, bad luck, but don't despair, for we have plenty of time. If a true princess is not found in the next few months, I shall go out and find one myself, or I don't deserve to wear my spurs.
Darling.
My love.
Do you remember the royal joust on Whitsunday when you won those spurs?
Of course.
When you were called Sir Harry, the fairest and bravest knight in all the land, and everyone agreed that you had a brilliant future ahead of you, that you might someday become Lord Chamberlain or even Prime Minister.
Well, I don't know about Prime Minister, but...
And do you remember the picnic we all had later on the greensward with the lovely cold pheasant?
Yes.
And you and I climbed the hill and watched the sun go down?
Yes.
And a lark was singing in the trees, and you said you'd remember that moment for forever because the lark's song reminded you of my name.
Yes, Larkin, yes.
And then we watched the sun go down.
Yes.
Well, I'm gonna have a baby. So you see, a princess for Dauntless must be found, and soon, or I shall have to go away somewhere. Oh, darling, I'm so worried. This could ruin you, and you'll never become Prime Minister or anything. Just say the word, and I'll go now. Just say the word, and I'll go far away where no one will find me. Just say the word.
Oh, no! You'll stay right here. Why should we both suffer just because you had a moment of weakness?
Oh, Harry.
We're none of us perfect. Everything is going to be all right.
Thank you, Harry.
It won't be long, it won't be long, it won't be, cause it can't be long. Before our dreams come true. Because you know I don't belong, and furthermore I shan't belong to anyone but you. In a little while, just a little while, you and I will be one, two, three, four. In a little while, I will see your smile on the face of my son to be forever hand in glove. Is the way I had it planned, but I'll only stay in love if the glove contains your hand.
In a velvet gown, I'll be coming down the aisle, and it's bound to seem as though the waiting's only been a little, in a little while.
Have you any idea how soon, my love?
November.
November?
My time is at a premium, for soon the world will see me. I'm eternal bride-to-be. I know I mustn't worry, Harry. Still, I'd wish you hurry, Harry. Harry, marry me.
In a little while, just a little while, you and I will be one, two, three, four. In a little while, I will see your smile on the face of my son to be forever hand in glove. Is the way I had it planned, but I'll only stay in love if the glove contains your hand. I can see it all down to every small detail. So I wish you'd look around until you found a castle in the neighborhood for sale.
Dauntless, don't startle. Dauntless, pick up your feet for heaven's sake and don't squint. I told you not to look at the sun.
Yes, Mama.
That's better. Sextimus! If I've told you once, I've told you 100,000 times. I will not have you playing these foolish games and running around in the halls. It just isn't dignified. We are the rulers of the kingdom, and if we don't set a proper example for the rest of the court, I'd like to know who will. I mean, what is the point of being a ruler if one isn't going to behave as a ruler should?
Mama?
Now what?
Mama, when am I going to get my princess?
Dauntless, I don't want to discuss that now. It's time for your cocoa.
But, Mama... Sometimes I get the funniest feeling You don't want me to get married.
Don't want you to get married. Don't want you to get married, Dauntless. Don't you trust me?
Well, of course, Mama.
Well, then how can you say such a thing? Of course I want you to get married. Only this morning I was saying to your father, I said, Sextimus, I want that boy to be married. It just isn't normal for a boy that age to stay single. And after all, he is the prince, I said. Don't forget that. He's next in line to the throne. I mean, we're not exactly the oldest people in the world. But on the other hand, we're not going to live forever. And I just know I'd feel much better, much easier, and more relaxed in my mind if that boy were married, settled, and set. And that is absolutely verbatim. Exactly what I said to your father this morning. Of course, he didn't say anything. He never does. But you know him just as well as I do, and I don't have to tell you how impossible he is. But that's my gross of pain. And if he makes me miserable and makes me suffer, I just have to put up with it. And I will not allow it to affect my child's attitude towards him or me. He may be a mean, a stupid, dreadful, selfish, rotten man, but he is your father. And I want you to respect him. There's only one person who really worries about you and cares about your health and your happiness and your future. And that's what I'm talking about right now, your future. And I want to make myself absolutely clear. I want you to get married, but I don't want you to marry just anybody. After all, marriage is a lifetime partnership, and I wouldn't want to see my little boy make the same mistake I did and wind up miserable the way I did. You are a prince, and you must marry someone suitable. Someone who's good enough and fine enough and smart enough for my nice, sweet, beautiful baby boy. And of course, she has to be a real princess. That's one thing I absolutely insist upon. She has to be a real, genuine, bona fide princess, just like me. Isn't that what you want? Someone like me? Oh, oh God, if I were only 20 years younger. Oh, just remember this. You must trust me.
Your Majesty, Your Highness.
Hi, Harry.
Don't interrupt.
Okay.
Well?
Sir Harry wishes to speak to you, madam.
Well?
Your Majesty, I have the honor to request a perilous labor. I wish to search for a true princess, one who will suit both Your Majesty and Prince Douglas.
No.
Mama!
No, no, no. We've been through all the eligible girls in all the neighboring kingdoms, and there are simply none left. We'll have to just wait until their little sisters grow up, and that'll take years. I mean, absolutely not. No, no, no.
But, Your Majesty, I plan to go north, over the mountains.
Over the mountains?
Across the Badlands.
Across the Badlands?
And into the swampland, where the beautiful marsh lily grows.
Marsh lily grows into the swampland. Are you out of your mind?
Oh, let him go, Mama, let him go.
You won't find anything there but frogs and tadpoles and things.
Mama.
Do you know what the weather there is like?
Mama, please.
Do you know how damp and just foggy and Mama. Just quiet? Humid and oppressive?
Mama, let Sir Harry try for me. Please.
All right. It's your sinus.
Hooray.
Come along, Dauntless. You've missed your cocoa.
Good luck, Sir Harry. Good luck.
Don't worry, little Arkin. I'll bring back a princess who's not only a true princess, but one who will be able to pass the queen's test.
I believe you. I'm not afraid.
And I shan't be away long.
Only fly as fast as you can, my love. We shall be waiting for you.
We?
You know. And wear this.
Next to my heart.
Just a little while, you and I will be 1, 2, 3, 4.
In a little while, I will see your smile on the face of my son to be forever hand in glove. Is the way I had it planned, but I'll only stay in love if the glove contains your hand. In a velvet gown, you'll be coming down the aisle, and it's bound to seem as though the waiting's only been a little, in a little while.
Mary's perilous journey took 3 weeks, and Lady Larkin had all but given up hope that he would find a true princess. Then, one sunny morning in mid-April, when the crocuses were just beginning to dot the meadows, the lookout in the north ground tower spied two distant figures approaching at full gallop. The alarm was spread. Sir Harry's back! Sir Harry's back! With the new princess! Now, let's see. How does this part go in the old story? On a stormy night to the castle door came the last the prince had been waiting for. That, of course, is utterly untrue. It didn't storm that night at all. In fact, it wasn't even night. And the princess only looked as though she'd come in from a storm stone.
Actually, I swam the moat. But never mind that. If I stand right here, there's a nice draft. I'll be dry in no time.
Look, Mama, she's all wet.
You swam the moat?
We tried to stop her, but she wouldn't wait for us to lower the drawbridge.
You swam the moat.
She's in the to arrive as soon as possible. We're gonna get a rope and pull her out.
You swam the moat?
All right, I was a little anxious. My friend, Sir Harry, he's still out there. He told me you had an opening for a princess. Any princess, I figured, the elephant! Anyway, here I am. Who's the lucky man? Hey, Nani, Nani, is it you? Hey, Nani, Nani, is it you? Hey, Nani, Nani, is it you, or you, or you, or you, or?
Nani, Nini, Nuni, Nani, Nini, Nani.
No, no, no!
Someone's being bashful. That's no way to be. Not with me. Can't you see that I am just as embarrassed as you? And I can understand your point of view. I've always been shy, I confess that I'm shy. Can't you guess that this confident air is a mask that I wear? Cause I'm shy, and you may be sure. Wait, how deep I'm demure. Though some people I know might deny it, at bottom I'm quiet and pure. My chances may pass me by. I pretend to be strong, but as weak as I am, all I can do is try. God knows I try. Though I'm frightened and shy, and despite the impression I give, I confess that I'm living a lie. Because I'm actually terribly timid and horribly shy. Though a lady may be dripping with glamour, as often as not, she will stumble and stammer when suddenly confronted with romance. And she's likely to fall on her face when she's finally face to face with a bear of fans. Quite often the lady not as hard to please as she seems. Quite often she'll settle for something less than the man of her dreams. I'm going fishing for a mate.
She's always fishing for a mate.
I'm gonna look in every brook.
She's gonna look in every brook.
But how much longer must I wait with bated breath and hope? Wonderful! and that is why, though I'm painfully shy, I'm in danger, oh, it's sir, you sir.
Not I, sir.
Then who, sir? Where, sir? And when, sir? I couldn't pretend, sir. So let's get this done, man. Get on with the fun, man.
I am one man.
The moat?
Does she ever say anything except you swam the moat? Do you ever say anything except you swam?
Do you mean for me to believe that you're a true princess of the royal blood? And am I actually to understand that you have the nerve, the gall, and the presumption to apply for my son's hand in marriage?
Mama, may I say something?
No!
Okay.
Do you imagine for one moment that I consider you suitable for any son of mine? You are laboring under a very unfortunate misapprehension, my dear. My son isn't going to marry any mouse swimmer, not while I have a breath in my body. And I haven't been well, not well at all. I get these shooting pains so dream. And don't try to tell me they're the vapors. I know what the vapors are. I had the vapors!
Are you new here? Well, watch closely. I take this perfect piece of paper with no cuts, folds, creases, or concerns.
It's a nut house!
No, wait!
You're the one, I guess.
Sure. I'm Prince Dauntless the Drab.
Well, glad to have met you.
No, please don't go. I like you. Everyone does. Almost everyone does.
Dauntless, I'd like to stay here, but I wouldn't want to come between you and your mother. So I guess I'll just face the facts, cut my losses, and head back to the swamps.
But I really like you.
You do?
Why? You swam the moat.
Dauntless, I know I swam the moat, but that's not the real me. I'm not like that. Actually, I'm really shy.
Well, you ought to see her swim, Mama. She's wonderful. Can I please marry your mama, please?
Marry her? Of course not. When you marry, if you marry, you'll marry yourself over.
I have the honor to announce the arrival of Her Royal Highness, the Princess Winifred.
You're a little late. That, Sir Harry, is no princess.
Ah, but she is, Your Highness.
What?
That one. Oh, you just... I swear she is, on my honor as a knight. I swear she is. I have her papers right here. Winifred, Princess of Icomkill, Guardian of the Midgard Serpent, and Warden of the Ragnarok Marsh Lily. Her family crest inscription reads, Tu ne cede malis, sed contra adentior ito.
What does that mean?
Roughly translated, it means if at first you don't
never
succeed.
Never mind.
You see, Mama, she is a real princess. At least a test. Mama, please.
All right. We'll test her. The wizard and I will make up a nice and fair test, just as we always do, and I'll prove to you that that girl could not possibly be a princess. We'll test her for sensitivity. She'll have her test and she'll fail just like all the others, fair and square.
Fail what?
Oh! Every princess suing for my hand must pass a test to prove she's a real princess.
Yes! Oh, well, we'll worry about that later. Right now,
I gotta get out of these wet clothes. May I show you part of the castle on the way to your room?
Sure.
You're awfully nice.
You're nicer.
You're good looking, too.
You're better looking and nicer, too.
Yeah, well, you're a better swimmer.
Your Majesty, I'm so excited. Sir Harry is back. Yes, and he's brought us a sweet princess. Have you met her? Well, neither have I, but I'm sure she's as delicate as an orange blossom. and I am to be her lady-in-waiting. Sir Harry arranged it. Isn't he thoughtful? He arranges everything. My father expected me to follow in his footsteps, but then I landed this jester job, Ben. What's wrong? You're worried about what? Who? Some lady. Which lady? Two syllables. First syllable. Bird. Some kind of bird. Auk. Bluebird. Catbird. Dove. Eagle. Finch. Grouse. Hawk. Jay. Kiwi. Lark. Martin. Lark?
Lady Larkin.
And a knight.
Oh, which knight?
Sir Harry! Dust. Sounds like dust. Lust.
No, must. Must what? You're going to start a war, right? Oh. Okay.
She's in trouble.
Oh, what kind of trouble?
Big trouble.
How many souls?
She's gonna have a baby. Does anybody else know? Sir Harry.
Of course. How does anyone else know besides Sir Harry?
Don't worry. We can keep a secret. The question is, can you?
We know you can't talk. You can't talk, but you can communicate.
You certainly do.
We have only two voices among us, and yet there's a third voice, a voice in disguise. You'll be hearing a trio and not a duet if you listen with both of your eyes. Kindly, with both of your... We produce a unique and remarkable blend when we raise our three voices on high. We're imperfect accord from beginning to the king and the minstrel and I. Yet if one of our trio should ever depart, then the others will languish and die. We're like three different people with only one.
The king and the jester and I.
Sing hey nani nani, hey nani nani, hi diddle diddle. Strike up a tune on the... Oh, the bishop declares our behavior is crude as he piously looks to the sky. Cause when we go wing swimming, we always go.
The king and the jester.
The king and the minstrel. Oh, the vintner makes wine from the grapes that he grows. 20 barrels were lost last July. Where they went is a secret that nobody but... Oh, the cook claims she's missing one chocolate cream roll and a fish that was ready to fry. Guess who's dining on pastry and filet up? Sing hey nani nani, hey nani nani, needle and thimble. Crash us a clash on the... It's been said of our king that his morals are loose, but the queen is much worse on the sly. Well, what's good for the gander is good for the... The king and the minstrel.
Have enough trouble trying to protect my only son from every catch-pity princess that comes along. And now I'm surrounded by spies and traitors. Whom can I trust?
Me.
No one. And now I have another one of those princesses to cope with, and I'm in no mood to sit in a chamber for hours and rack my brain over a test for that girl when I'm not at all feeling well. But that's the way Dauntless wants it. That's the way it'll be. She'll have her test.
Well, her papers seem to be in order.
I know! And the worst of it is that the foolish boy actually seems to like the girl. So we must think of a test that looks fair, and seems fair, and sounds fair, and isn't fair. When you got the idea of testing her for sensitivity, I could have applauded right out loud! But exactly what?
Table manners.
No, that's not good enough. Sensitivity, sensitivity, I'm just loaded with that. In this one word is the epitome of the aristocrat. Sensitive soul and sensitive stomach, sensitive hands and feet. This is the blessing, also the curse of being the true elite. Common people don't know what exquisite agony is. Suffered by gentle people like me. Just get your hands off me. Think of a tricky test for that wretched moat swimming princess.
Madam Tay, I suggest. Maybe we ought to.
Don't take all night. I'm not well. I need my rest. Not that I ever sleep on that lumpy mattress. Oh God, my back. Sensitivity, bane of royalty, that mental torture wreck. Oh, I hate to sound grumpy, but my nerves are so jumpy. I am sure I could feel any lump, even if it were under the mattress and small as a pea. That's the answer, under the mattress. We'll test her tonight. One tiny pea beneath one thick downy mattress. Oh God, you're bright. Any genuine princess would feel it if she doesn't. She's get the tiniest pea and order one mattress. No, make it two.
Why not five?
10, I think, would be plenty. Better still, make it 20. And to play it safe in the event, even that's not enough to ensure that she sleeps. We'll give her a soothing sedative, won't we? You can whip up a drink. Something stunning! Oh, my dear Dumblish, I love the way you think. She's insensitive, so insensitive, she'll fall asleep, no doubt. God, but you're clever, really, a genius. You are divine. Get out!
Get into something dry. This old dress is just soaked.
Your Highness, the King has asked to meet the young lady.
Why? He's never asked before.
He heard she swam the moat.
Dauntless, is your father anything like your mother? Because if he is...
Oh, no, my father's silent.
I'd love to meet him.
Papa? This is Princess Winifred.
Your Highness, the King welcomes you. And he asked me to say he hopes you get 100 on the test tomorrow.
Oh, well, thanks.
My father never touches his crown to his heart unless he really means it.
Alas, madam, the King is mute, or he would speak for himself. He's still under a curse cast by a witch long ago, before Prince Dauntless was born. The curse says King Sextimus will never talk until the mouse devours the hawk.
Until the mouse devours the hawk? Well, can't you just get a big mouse and a little hawk and...
We tried that once, but the mouse got scared and ran away. And the hawk bit Daddy.
Ooh, well, Let me just get this test under my belt. We'll figure something out. Don't you worry. It certainly has been a pleasure meeting His Majesty. A short while ago, I had the pleasure of meeting Her Majesty. Now that is a nice man.
Your Highness, I think you better speak to Prince Dauntless very soon about, you know.
About what?
Your father feels he's been neglecting his duty. And now that you're old enough to get married, he feels you ought to have a little talk, you know. Man to man.
You mean about things? You mean now?
Well, maybe it'd be best to wait until later. Your father says there are a few facts he still wants to look up first.
Well, I certainly do like almost both your parents, Dauntless.
We want you to be happy here. We know it's a lot different from what you're used to.
Yeah, it is a little hard making the adjustment to dry land and everything.
You must feel like a fish out of water.
As a matter of fact, I do. You see, where I come from, we don't have any dry land. I mean, some of the poor people do, but all the nobility live right in the swamp with their servants and pets.
Did you have pets?
Lots.
Dogs?
Frogs. I come from the land of the foggy, foggy dew. Ooh, ooh, ooh. Where walking through the meadow in the morning is like walking through blue. The swamps of home are brushed with green and gold at break of day.
At break of day.
The swamps of home are lovely to behold from far away.
From far away.
In my soul is the beauty of the fog. In my memory is the magic of the blood. I know that blood is thicker than water, but the swamps of home are thicker than blood. Where I roam, my heart grows thick and cold. My face grows gray when shadows fall and I hear the call. I hear them calling me now, calling me back, calling me Winifred, 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 Winifred. Who do you think you are, girl of the swamps? You've gone too far, maid of the marshland. Give up the struggle. Listen to the voice of the swamps.
La 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 la.
You do? Okay.
No, Dauntless, it's bad luck to see too much of the bride before the wedding.
May I show you the gowns now, Your Highness?
Yes.
Now,
Here are the very latest things. They do such lovely work, don't you think? Notice the fullness in the back and the window-cut sleeves cutting down. It's really you. It looks marvelous on, don't you think so, ladies? Perhaps Your Highness would like to look in the mirror.
Perhaps Your Highness has a favorite color?
Well, back home we wear a lot of dark greens and earth browns. But I guess my own dress there is my favorite color. Huckleberry? Tell you what, I'll just go to the fourth floor later and try them on.
Very well, Your Highness. Ladies!
Come in.
Oh, I guess we won't need you, Emily. They already sent a girl up to the floor. You're new here, aren't you?
Yes,
Well, remember, we're all here to do one job, and your job is just as important as everyone else's. Oh, dear, sweet, lovely Princess Winifred, you will pass the Queen's test. You will. Grimacy, my dear. You can't possibly clean the floor with such a tiny patch. You need a good, big, wet rag. Here, what's this?
That's my huckleberry.
Use this old thing. Just look at this mess. Oh, my gentle princess, think of me. Do you know what it means to me to be the lady-in-waiting to the blessed Winifred? Oh, Winifred, Winifred, what name is sweeter than that? Ugh, just look at that table, it's dripping wet. Here, I'll use this. I can't bear to see the delicate beauty of my royal mistress in such a messy place. Get that, please. Quick, quick, quick!
Your Highness!
Harry!
What?
How are you? Oh, get up, you don't have to go through the motions with me. Say, I'm awfully sorry about, you know, swimming the moat. I hope I didn't make a bad impression.
Oh, not at all, Your Highness. And if you'll just give your wet dress to one of the ladies in waiting, she'll see that it's taken care of.
Thank you, it's already been taken care of.
I see you've met my dear Lady Larkin.
So this is the little Larkin girl.
The very same, Your Highness.
Oh, Harry, she's beautiful and a bundle of energy.
When I gaze now upon that captivating face, I realize how poor my description must have been.
Sir Harry's not very good at describing people, Your Highness.
Well, he may not know how to describe them, but he sure knows how to pick them. Now, if you'll excuse me, I gotta try some dresses on the fourth floor.
I've never been so humiliated in my life.
What's the matter?
I thought she was a chambermaid.
A chambermaid?
A chambermaid!
Larkin, how could you? How could you mistake the princess for a chambermaid?
How could I? How could you mistake that chambermaid for a princess?
Oh, don't say such a thing. Just because you made a stupid mistake.
I made a mistake? Don't you dare try to blame it on me.
I do blame it on you.
She was on her hands and knees scrubbing the floor.
She was a real lady wherever she was. That's more than I can say for some people around here.
I hate you!
Well, I hate you too!
Get out!
Don't worry, I'm going!
Goodbye!
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 You're a wizard. You should be able to think of something to help that wizardane to sleep. Now, don't forget to whip us up a sleeping potion and some of that good heavy incense. And the hypnotic mirror. Wait, the most important thing is that she's tired out first. We'll have an official ball tonight. We'll make wizardane dance until she drops. Now, what can we do? Do you know the Saracen Brawl? No, 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 that's not tiring enough. I have it. We'll do that new dance, the Spanish Panic. It's absolutely exhausting. Do you know it? Well, it's the Rage in Venice. Everybody listen! There's to be an official ball tonight, and everyone is to attend. We're all going to do that new dance, the Spanish Panic, so you might as well learn it now. The basic step is flip your skirts, open, close, open, close, open, close, open, close, right, right, right. It's like the magic step, only forward, just that easy. Suppose we all try it. Flip your skirts, open, close, open, close, open, close, open, close, right, right, wrong! Doesn't anyone know the Spanish Panic? Oh, well, thank heaven someone is up to date around here. Why don't we all watch while court dancer Sir Harold and Lady Beatrice demonstrate? Now, was that hard? Suppose we all try it. Take partners, please. Pepperde, eat! Don't you just love it? Doesn't it make you want to fly? Whee!
Lost her. All right, Your Majesty, I'll help you.
Has he ever had any success?
Well,
I've been here a month and he hasn't caught a door yet.
I'll tell you what, tomorrow we'll set up a trap. Not a bit. Someone's coming.
Who?
The Queen!
And this has to be the biggest. And when I say the biggest, I mean the loudest ball we've ever had. And be sure to hire extra musicians for tonight's dancing. Not that I'll be able to enjoy any of it with my back. Oh, the strange nagging pain in my jaw. Oh, God.
No one would ever know what I suffer.
What was she jabbering about? The Queen is going to make us do something?
What?
Exercise?
Someone's coming?
Oh. My lady, is everything all right?
Yes.
Well, we're glad of that anyway.
I felt faint, that's all. I was sitting in my room sewing, and it got a little stuffy, so I decided to come out for some air.
I see we're planning to camp out for a while.
Oh, Your Majesty, you don't know. You just don't know. Do you know what can happen in a relationship between a man and a woman? Well, I'm glad I found out when I did. It's better this way. I'm leaving.
You're leaving?
Yes. I'm leaving the service of the Queen forever.
That's a pretty big step to take all alone.
I have no choice.
You're leaving forever?
Yes.
You'll need help.
But who would help me?
I, my lady.
What did you say? You want to take care of Lady Larkin. Who's gonna take care of you?
Chivalry demands that we protect the damsel in distress.
If you say so, Your Majesty.
But she'll have to travel light, the way a man.
Yes, she'll go as a boy. We can steal one of Prince Dauntless' suits. We'll get these things out of your way. You can wait in your room.
No, I don't need help from anyone, thank you. I can go alone.
Over the wall?
Yes, I don't need help from anyone.
You'll be all right once you get past the water rats.
Rats? Oh, yes. They live over the edges of the stagnant pools near the quicksand.
Quicksand?
Beyond the wall.
Slime? Spiders?
Oh, they won't hurt you unless, of course, you plan to go alone.
Well, I was, but if I'd known it'd be so terrible out there.
Can you take a second thought and come with me? I have all the secret ways to get us through. Over the hills and to the open sea.
Then where?
Oh, that's April, isn't it?
April?
Normandy is fine and fair. So Normandy is where we'll go. Facing the sea. This time of year, the air I hear is rare and clear and warm in Normandy.
I know a man of color with mustard flowers crawling at the sun. Where will wonders can happen when in April day is done? After the sun sets, when the sky is suddenly green, and the world stands hushed and waiting, all the birds fly as far as they can be. When you see that emerald sky, don't know the reason why. There's not another place I'd rather be.
Keep your El Dorado, and to hell with Burgundy. Come fly with me. Come try those wings. Come swim for me. Have things to do.
Is there truly a beach where the peach blossom blows? Are you sure you can reach a man who knows a man who knows a cozy end? A friend.
White lilac.
The sea.
could give me a clue.
A clue?
Well, I know it's highly secret, but what sort of test does she usually give?
Well, with Mama thinking of the test, it could be almost anything.
Like what?
Sometimes it's history.
Oh.
Sometimes it's dancing. Sometimes it's spelling.
Oh.
But sometimes it's a test of strength and endurance.
Aha!
For instance, one of the girls was supposed to lift this weight, but she couldn't. I can't even lift it. But I'm sure you'll pass. You don't have to worry.
Do you want me to pass? I'll pass.
Hey, I think you're wonderful.
By the way, I don't think I ever told you. My full name is Winifred the Woe Be Gone. But Winifred's too formal. You could just call me by my nickname.
Winnie?
Fred.
Fred. What a beautiful name. So straight, so strong. So you. I like you, Fred. I like you.
You're just saying those words to be kind.
No, I mean it. I love you, Fred.
He is out of his medieval mind.
I'm perfectly sane and sound. I've never felt better in my life. Everybody, everybody, everybody come and meet my incipient wife. I'm in love with a girl named Fred. My reasons must be clear. When she shows you all how strong she is, you'll stand right up and cheer.
F-R-E-D-F-R-E-D-Fred, yeah!
I'm in love with a girl named Fred. She drinks just like a lord, so come sing a merry drinking song and let the wine be poured. I'm in love with a girl named Fred. She sings just like a bird. You'll be left completely speechless when her gentle voice is heard. I'm in love with a girl named Fred. She wrestles like a Greek. You will clap your hands and wonder at her fabulous technique. Girl named Fred. She dances with such grace. You are bound to sing her praises till you're purple in the face.
Bravo, bravo, bravissimo, bravo, bravissimo.
Fred, she's musical to boot. She will set your feet a tapping when she plays upon her lute.
Bravo, bravo, bravissimo, bravo, bravissimo.
I'm in love with a girl named Fred. A clever, clownish wit. When she does her funny pantomime, your sides are sure to split.
Thank you.
20 downy mattresses, that's one thing I absolutely insist upon. And when I... And when I say 20, I mean 20. Quiet!
Get them out of here. Lay low until the coast is clear. Bravo, bravo, bravissimo.
Bravo, bravo, bravissimo.
Jester. Oh, Jester. I cannot believe that Jester has the audacity to create more chaos in my kingdom when I'm already surrounded by spies and traitors who don't respect me. And I'm just so sensitive, so, so sensitive, so it hurts me worse. Not to mention, Dauntless falling in love with that mouth swimmer, or whatever her name is. I want order in this kingdom, and I will get order if it's the last thing I do, and I need the perfect mattress. Just why? Why does he want that swamp swimming? Shift the eye! Oh, you wretch! I want the truth! Now, what is all this noise about anyway? The moment I turn my back, something outrageous is going on in the corridors. Go! Go! Get her now! Go! 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 Oh, and go, 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 go! There she goes, there she goes! Get her, now, now! Quick, quick, quick! OMG, my back! And then this smooth swimmer, and then there's Dauntless. My favorite son, by the way, Miss Zin is Dauntless. I just can't stop! Now, you wretch, I knew something was up! What are you doing? What are you up to? What? There's something going on around here. What's under the mattress? It's a dead body. Pull that away. Well, what are you doing? Explain yourself.
it's just a joke, Your Majesty. This boy and I, go outside and wait for me, Lancelot.
Lancelot! Wait. Lady Luggett! Take those things to what's her name's chamber. Mattresses too.
Your mattress.
Quiet! What are you doing in this ridiculous getup?
Please.
Silence! Why weren't you at the ball? Shut up! And why are you with this man? Answer me. Well, speak up. You were running away. Is that it? You are running away? Why, you lowborn, ungrateful little sneak! Is this the thanks I get for treating you as one of my own daughters? Just look at you! One of my girls running off with a musician!
Your Majesty, the Lady Larkin is innocent. I will tell you this. I forced her to leave against her will.
That's not true.
Just a moment. May I remind you that you are still one of my ladies in waiting? Get up upstairs where you belong and prepare what's her name for bed. And I order order this minstrel banished from my kingdom, and I want him out of here by daybreak. And Sextimus, go to bed. I don't want you groping around all night in the dark. And the rest of you, listen closely. There's a little girl who was upstairs who was dog tired.
For her test.
All right. Well, let her study. But when she goes to bed, I want quiet around here. Is that clear? I want quiet, and I'm going to get quiet if I have to scream the palace down. Quiet!
Some. S-U-M. Some.
Summer.
Summer. S-U-M-E-R. Summer.
Good. Well, if Mama tests you in literature or spelling, you're sure to pass, right?
Yeah!
Woo! That leaves history.
History? Well, that takes in quite a lot, but let's give it a whirl.
The first chapter is called The Bravery of Prince Waldare.
Waldare.
Young Waldare, wishing to slay the dragon Fafnir.
Who?
Wishing to slay the dragon Fafnir.
Oh yeah, Fafnir, that one.
Takes his father's sword, Minning.
Minning.
Disguised as the West Wind, he goes into the forest, surprises Fafnir in his lair, and slays him. Whereupon he is enabled to understand the speech of birds. Meanwhile, Waldare's father, Alberich, disguised as the sacred goat, tells him that the spirit of Gunther...
Oh yeah, Gunther! Wait, but I thought that, you know... Did you ring for a page boy?
Nuh-uh.
You've got the wrong room, son. Wait, aren't you Larkin?
Yes, Your Highness.
What's the matter?
I have a suit just like that.
I'm in disguise, Your Highness. I was trying to run away.
I see. Well, sit down and rest. Dauntless, pull up a chair.
But the Queen has ordered
Never
me.
Never mind what the Queen has ordered. Just sit here.
But Your Highness...
Oh, just sit down. Now, what's this all about?
I'll just go out on the parapet, stand there naked, catch a chill, and die. That'll show him.
Show him what?
He'll be sorry.
Who will be sorry?
Horrible Harry.
You mean big, nice Harry?
Just a moment. What did you do to him?
What did I do to him?
Well, you must have done something. You're talking the way I did once when I was too afraid to go home because I'd given my little brother a bloody lip. It was an accident.
We had a little disagreement.
So you decided to run away?
He said some perfectly horrible things to me.
I see. Well, in that case, I guess you're right. I guess about the only thing you can do is pack up and get out. Unless, of course, you go to him and say you're sorry. Look, that Harry is a wonderful boy and he really loves you. Why, we were on the road for 2 weeks and he never laid a finger on me.
Oh, Your Highness.
Now, you just put on something pretty that shows you're a girl and patch things up with him. Oh, and Larkin, try to act a little helpless. Men don't like girls that are too strong.
Oh, I do.
Oh, Princess, how can I ever thank you? If it's a girl, I'm gonna name her Fred.
Well, what if it's a boy?
Dauntless, you better go to bed. Oh, and leave the history book.
I'm positive you'll pass Mama's test tomorrow. But I'm pretty sure. If you don't, I'll understand.
And so, the young prince, Waldare, having slain the dragon, Fafnir, with the sword Minning, rescued the princess, Frigga, and together they mounted his horse, Trigga, and rode to the castle, Wunderbar, where they were married and lived happily ever after.
Well,
happily leaving the chapel eternally die. As the curtain descends, there is nothing but loving and laughter. When the fairy tale ends, the heroine's always a bride. Ella, the girl of the cinders, did the watch and the walls and the winders, till she landed a prince who was brawny and blue-eyed and blonde. Still, I honestly doubt that she could ever have done it without that crazy lady. With the wand Cinderella had outside help, I have no one but me. Fairy godmother, 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 where can you be? I don't have a fairy godmother. I don't even have a godmother. I have a mother, a plain, ordinary woman. Snow White was so pretty, they tell us that the queen was insulted and jealous when the mirror declared that Snow White was the fairest of all. She was dumped on the border, but saved by some men that adore her. Oh, I grant you, they were small, but there were seven of them, practically a regiment. I'm alone in the night, by myself, not a dwarf, not an elf, not a goblin in sight. That girl had seven determined little men working day and night just for her. Oh, sure, the queen gave her a poison apple. Even so, she lived happily, happily, happily ever after. A magical kiss counteracted the apple eventually. Oh, I know I'm not clever. I'll do what they tell me I have to. I want some happily ever after to happen to me. Rapunzel had platinum tresses that were double the length of her dresses. She was kept in a tower for years by a wicked old witch. Till one night in despair, down she scrambled by letting her hair down. That's what I call quite a switch. I wonder, no, it'll never hold. I'll be finished before I begin. And besides, I don't want to get out. I want to get in. I want to live happily, happily, happily ever after. I want to walk happily out of the chapel eternally. Die, for I know that I'll never live happily ever after.
This man was charged with attempting to transport a young woman out of kingdom against her will. And that is a very serious offense.
He didn't do it. It was a frame-up.
You've got it all wrong.
He was protecting the Lady Larkin. And you keep out of this, Your Majesty.
Sir Harry, I can't leave just yet. There's someone I must see first.
Who?
The wizard. I want your permission to speak to the wizard.
Yes, yes!
No, no. Permission denied.
Sir Harry, you're a bad man.
Yes, you are. He's trying to help. We're all trying to help.
How can you help?
Oh, by finding out what the test is from the wizard.
That's cheating. Oh.
Don't you understand? This is for you.
Let me go to the wizard.
No, I mean, if anyone should defy the wizard's magic, it should be me.
You must stand guard. This is my job. No, 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 no. You might get hurt. You can't come, and that's final.
What's the matter, Papa?
The king mustn't come with us.
I'll get rid of him. Your Majesty! Prince Dauntless is ready now. He needs to have that personal talk with you.
Maybe some other time?
Dauntless, your father wants to have a little chat with you now. It's very important.
It is?
It can't be put off. Come on. Do your duty, sire.
What is it, Papa? What do you want to talk about? Heart to heart? Man to man? Well, Papa, stop. Look. Listen. Boy. Flower. Girl flower. Oh, tell me more. I want to know about what getting married is for. Seed. Fall. On girl flower. By and by. Baby flower. Grow. Oh, but why? Oh, tell me why. Oh, Father, tell me, Father, don't be shy. Oh, boy flower, girl flower, love each other. Boy flower, father, girl flower, mother. Yes, yes, but how? It's very interesting, but how? Oh, tell me now. On boy flower dust gets on bee. Bee fussed a girl flower, dust touches girl flower. Oh, I see. No, I don't see. It's very interesting, but still not clear to me. Woman is like girl flower, man is like bee, and like boy flower. Man, that's me! But tell me more. I've got to know about what getting married is for. Sounds like Carrie. Sounds like married. Man and woman get married. Winifred and White. Love each other. And then one night. Yes, yes, one night. It's very interesting what happens in the night. What happens, oh Father, tell me please. Shall I go and pick some flowers? Shall I go and catch some bees? Princess Winifred? And I? We'll get married. And then one night. The stork! The stork will come and bring us a baby. Oh, Father, I know all about the stork. Mama told me about that years ago. No, 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 wait a minute, Father.
Flower, seed, man, woman, bee, baby, small. It isn't the stork, it isn't the stork, it isn't the stork at all. Oh, life is grand, it's very interesting. I think I understand, I think I know. It's very interesting. Thank you, Father, and Father, I love you. So
myself.
wizard.
What do you want?
Our friend the minstrel's a great admirer of yours.
No soft soap, if you please.
This is not soft soap. And I wouldn't even say it except for the fact that I've been banished. Well, I hope this one breaks you, but I have to tell you what a great artist you are.
Cardamom. Don't call me by that name.
I use that name with honor, sir. I don't think I'll ever forget seeing you in command performance at Classic Berry in 92. What a show, what a triumph. You took 7 curtain calls.
8.
Do you happen to remember a little boy who stood up in the second row and yelled, "Bravo!" that night?
I do.
I was that boy.
I can't believe it.
Yes, of course. Now I'm in show business too. And if it's any interest to you, it was your inspiration that brought us to that.
You must belong to the guild. Bing bong, woo, woo, woo!
Hey!
Huzzah! Camelot, local 714. To think that somebody remembers those days? Oh.
Now, I just want to tell you what that performance meant to me, Carl. Well, I better be gone.
Oh, no, stay a while, Sir Minstrel. Stay a while. Yes, yes. Here, have a seat.
No, the queen would have liked it if she was all around.
Never mind her, this is between us. Sit down.
Well, anyway, you're probably busy for that test for tomorrow.
Oh, that's all right. The test's been taken care of.
Say, I don't suppose you can tell him, old your brother, what it is.
Well, I'm sort of under oath.
Ah, you understand. Well, I'd better be going now.
Sir Minstrel, may I borrow a handkerchief?
What handkerchief?
My cock! Doodle-doo. Yes. Some people think my act is pretty foul.
Cardamom the Great!
I bet you'll never guess what the test is about.
Astronomy?
No. You'll never guess. Sensitivity!
Sensitivity.
Sensitivity.
Did you hear? Cardamom the Great.
Cardamom the Great Test. Here. Now, let me tell you the rest. I'd better not. No.
I'll go, but may I ask one favor? May I have this?
What do you want with that?
A memento of the good old days, because of my father.
Keep it.
Thank you.
Jester. Bing bong. Whoa.
Hey!
Shh. Huzzah! Yes. Yes.
That was a wonderful thing you did for that girl.
Well, for her father's sake. Yes.
Say, I don't actually have to be out of until the day you you and I go down to the wine cellars, put a bottle, talk some more about, talk some more.
Fine, but I've started something here that I'd like to finish. Oh, so okay. Go ahead. I'll join you in 2 seconds.
I'll be waiting.
Time for myself. Yes, right there. A little bit more. Oh, thank you. Just enough.
Thank you.
far from sentimental or romantic. And I like to think that I'm strictly up to date. But at times the dancing gets a bit too frantic in these hectic days of 1428. So indulge me as I pause to raise my chalice to a quaint and charming dance they used to do in the days when my dear father played the palace back in 1392. My dad was debonair and quite as light as air. In his very soft shoes, how he could dip and glide and skip and slip and slide. In his very soft shoes, I used to stand and watch him every day. He was always smooth and cool. I used to love to hear the people say, he's a regular dancing fool. He barely touched the ground and never made a sound. But I've noticed in all his reviews that when he took his bow to the crowd and the crowd went crazy and the house came down. When Daddy wore his very soft shoes.
Blame you if you've changed.
Well, in a way I have. Yesterday I loved you as never before. But please don't think me strange. I've undergone a change. And today I love you even more. My heart cannot I give you fair warning, I openly confess. Tonight I love you less than I will tomorrow morning.
Yesterday I loved you as never.
as anyone ever could be. Now I see what tricks my eyes can play. Yesterday I must have been utterly blind, or else I was out of my mind. For I find you so much lovelier today. My heart cannot be trusted, I give you fair warning. For yesterday I loved you as never before. But that was long ago, and now it's best to know. I love you even more. My heart cannot be trusted, I give you fair warning. I tremble at your touch, not nearly half so much as I will tomorrow morning.
In a gentle trance, deep in Morpheus's arm we lie, off we go to Betty Boy!
You know, I think I'm getting a zit right there.
Oh, bring the poppy and the magical incense. Drowsy incense, sweet aroma, wraps us in a gentle coma, murmuring voices seem to say, Mr. Sandman's on his way. Now that ought to get us to sleep, shouldn't it? I hope so. The sleeping draught.
Here, madam.
That's right, drink a little extract of opium and warm up before going to bed. Like I always say, drink it down.
This looks good.
Now I'm sure you're going to get a good night's rest. I wish I could say the same for myself. But to make sure you have no trouble drifting off, I have prepared an extra special consolation prize. Bring on the Nightingale of Sandmarket. Who has the Nightingale of Sandmarket? Naturally, I have to do everything myself. Right, sing. Stop! You were brought here to put a live princess to sleep, not to wake a dead one. Now let's have a lullaby, birdie, nice and soft. Yes, 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 girlie. Now, my dear, why aren't you in bed? person in this castle is going to get a good night's sleep.
What are you, some kind of nut? All right, Lumps. Watch out. All right, let's take it from the top.
I can dress myself.
Well, far be it to me interfere, precious.
I can do it.
Why are you wearing that so early in the morning?
Well, today's the test, Mama.
Why, the test, sweetheart. The test is over.
Huh?
The test is over, darling boy.
But, Mama, when was it? What was it?
It was last night. We put her to sleep on 20 soft, downy mattresses with a pea under the bottom one. And, of course, the pea would have kept a real princess awake.
And she slept?
Well, I'm sure I don't know, but she was practically falling asleep before she got to bed and yawning like a kitchen maid. I mean, she looks ghastly and old enough to be your mother. Oh, well. We'll see.
Oh, Fred.
Quiet!
I can't help it.
Quiet! Control yourself. They'll be here in a minute.
If she doesn't pass, I'll just kill myself.
Stay quiet. Here she comes.
And someday, dear, we'll find yourself a true princess, so don't worry. Good morning, everyone.
Good morning, Your Majesty.
All here to see the princess on her way, since she's such a favorite of ours. I have decided to prepare an extra special consolation prize. Sir Studley.
Here, Your Majesty, a very thoughtful gift.
Charming, charming. Dauntless, now where is our little Slugabed? She shouldn't have gotten an early start. Ah, there she is! She isn't even dressed. She must have slept like a baby.
37,428.
37,428 what?
Sheep. What do you stuff your mattresses with, jousting equipment?
What do you mean?
I mean that bed ought to be moved down to the torture chamber.
You didn't sleep?
I never shut my eye.
You passed!
Passed what?
The test! Mama put a pea under 20 mattresses and you felt it, and now we could be married!
A pea under 20 mattresses? No wonder I'm black and blue.
Now, don't you think she's pretty?
No, she's not pretty. She's beautiful.
20 mattresses, huh? Dauntless, dear. I'll leave the wedding arrangements up to you. You'd better start looking around for a small kingdom for us. I got a feeling we're not going to want to live with the in-laws.
She's tired. I better take her to her room.
Dauntless, wait.
What should I wait for, Mama?
To give this matter proper consideration.
She passed the test, and now I have to take her up to our room.
I said wait! Now you listen to your mother. And throughout this heart-breaking business of trying to find a A true princess. I have never nagged, never interfered, and never expected one solitary word of sympathy.
Mama, she's asleep.
But I will not stand by and watch you throw yourself away to that little nobody.
Mama, quiet.
I mean, she may have passed the test, but I always say I've never trusted anyone with them shifty little eyes or that...
Mama! Little... I told you to shut up!
Oh, it happened! It happened! The prophecy! The mouse devoured the hawk!
The queen can't talk!
I...
What?
I can! And I've got a lot to say! Go on, Adam.
Good night.
Run along. Now you've asked for Agravain, and you've got it. When I say hop, I want you to hop, hop, skip, jump, hop,